Erica, as I understand it, you just worked on the UNESCO Caribbean AI policy roadmap. Can you share with us a little bit about what you learned from that experience?
Yes, and it was very exciting to be a part of that experience, Pia Milan, and to really develop my understanding and help the region and all of us to develop our understanding of where we are in the world in terms of our AI adoption, our use, our education. And I'll just mention a few learnings along the way. I've mentioned one before that we definitely are experiencing AI on a daily basis here in the Caribbean, just because the technologies are being deployed on our cell phones. We're interacting with Netflix and Spotify and all of those products that we interact with on a daily basis. Citizens are interacting with AI. What we are not doing, though, is the development work, working on solutions for AI. Not a lot of companies. I think Eldon Marks is one of those people who has a company focused on AI. But when you look at the region, we're not very focused on it as a product offering, right? The second thing that we noticed is the education, as Stacey just talked about, the awareness. Now, I want to congratulate Cordell and everything that they have done at the Broadcasting Commission of Jamaica. They're probably one of the countries that are out front in the evangelism of AI, educating the citizens on the possibilities available. So good work for the Broadcasting Commission of Jamaica, but we definitely need to see the other countries take up media and information literacy regarding artificial intelligence. So we're not seeing a lot. Maybe some of you all can adopt the best practices that are going on in Jamaica with the Broadcasting Commission. Third big point, Pia Milan, is just really the lack of information on the topic from a research perspective. So looking for researchers, we have wonderful universities in the region, as Cordell said, scholars across all kinds of topics, but not a lot of research in the area of artificial intelligence, in even the areas where we could use it for benefit, like our climate change issues that we have. How do we apply the technology to assist us with prediction, or even after a hurricane comes, how do we marshal forces to be able to respond in a resilient manner? So the data is not there. So we have to start increasing more in the university level, implementing and talking about it and writing about it. There were less than 10 academic papers written in this area in the region. So most of the research that we were doing with the paper really was outside of the region, seeing what the best practices were, what's happening in the other parts of the world, and trying to see how we were going to do it here in Jamaica. Another profound point that I would like to make is the fact that we don't really have a coordinated approach to artificial intelligence and even general technologies in the region, right? We're taking it island by island, and we are trying to go it alone and individually. And obviously, we're too small. It's not a scalable approach. So we need to see how we're going to collaborate a lot more across our islands to be able to really make something out of artificial intelligence and the opportunity ahead. We have to invest, though, Pia, because to be honest, we don't have the infrastructure that's needed to support artificial intelligence in the region. And really, we need processing power in the form of GPUs. We need cloud offerings located in the region, not in other places. So our region, our countries in the region should really look at coming together to see how we're going to build the infrastructure that will form the foundation for building other solutions on top of it. But we can't really be in the game unless we have those technologies resident in the region. And those were just some of the findings. I think we have a very exciting opportunity for us in some of our industry sectors, such as tourism. Tourism and artificial intelligence would be a great specialization for us in the region. we have the domain expertise here, right? Everybody knows it's a great place to come and visit. How do we take that domain expertise about tourism, join it with this general purpose technology, and become a leader in those types of solutions for the market? So if people want to come up with technology, AI-based technology products, or they want those solutions, they should be coming to our region, right? We know the product, we know tourism. So how do we support those industries that we're already in with this technology, with something that we talked about in the paper? And then how do we look at new sectors that we can really tackle? Like the esports, that was a big one, right? We are really great in the physical realm in terms of sporting. Everybody knows we've got the fastest man in the world and the fastest woman in the world, right? So we know something about that. So how do we take something like a new sort of spin, e-sporting, and take our domain knowledge and then transform it into a new industry sector? Because remember, we're going after wealth generation here in our region. So we have to go after the new. It's better possibilities for us to generate wealth when we're looking at new sectors. So I was just really thrilled to be a part of the research team and really bolstering up my knowledge in this area of artificial intelligence in the Caribbean. I'm extremely encouraged though, Pia, for all the challenges that we have and we have had. I think the research showed that we have great possibility. We have wonderful talent in the region. And as Cordell said, if we can get some more investment to bolster up our education, like Stacy said, we'll be in a great position. So we need to really look at the positive part of this and try to go for it.